Hello friends, welcome back in my YouTube channel CodePlay. So first of all, congratulate to all of you. Happy New Year 2020, and I hope this January will be fantastic. So let's come to the point. Today point is how to perform CRUD operation using database first in ASP.NET MVC. So first of all, we have to create project for MVC. So let's click on create button, search here ASP.NET. Click on ASP.NET data application, click on next, database first, rename the project database. Click create and choose the MVC, and you can check configure for HTTPS or not. So we have tried, so I have one check. Will this create MVC project? Click on here and check the app startup file, route config here. Let me demonstrate. Route config.cl file, set the routing for your request and response. URL, filter config using your filter, and there are different type of filter in MVC, like authentication, authorization, and execution filter, action filter, and result filter. And exception filter. There are five filters in MVC. So here is a defined global filter collection. This filter contains all filters. So first of all, this filter, this file registers all filters. And bundle configuration dot cf, in which this is the this file, this CS file used for the register your jQuery like JS file and CSS file. Which load only once in your project. So let's come to the point. First of all, we have to create a database because we are going to use database first. Select your click on Explorer Management Studio, click on your database, and you name the database database. Let's create some pages. Create I and file ID. Event. Send this primary key and auto increment. Identity and specification. Mandate. IEMC name, and that's your IEMC salary, money, IEMC, okay. And use 200 and IMC status. Goal for this data IMC content and last column is A IMC AR created data. So, date time column. Save this. Serial employee and employee. Okay, so on to the SAM model. In your application, add the model. So click on add, click on new item, click on data tab, and every dot net entity model. Select your SQL. You can rename any type of name. You can rename and you can choose model name. Select EF designer from database. Click on that. And need to create a connection between here. So you can see it here. Select new connection. Click on here. Select SQL server. Authenticate your SQL. Select your database. You can click this. This connection of this. Okay. Now first, when you creating model first time, you have to check here, include the sensitive return connection. Then you create first time the model, this connection is to insert in the your base config file for the connection purpose. Okay. So rename your base config connection is to name. Okay, so click on next. If you can select the framework, pluralize or singularize, include warranty column. When you deselect this checkbox, then if your table, if your database contains multiple tables and multiple tables contains warranty and primary key agent, but some tables does not contain warranty or primary key, then your model creates both. For both tables, but if you have primary key and non-primary key tables, so if you check this, then only warranty or primary key should create the model for that table. Otherwise, this table does not contain any warranty or primary key. That table will not be part of that model. Okay, so pluralize or singularize also means when it is basically for the when your model will create, and when you check this, then your model name should be pluralized or singularized. Like S will in the last of your model name, S will add. Like if your table name is employee, then when you check this and finish this, then your model name will be employee. So it depends on if you want or not. So let me select this, and here is the option. You can choose the particular for the table, and if you have view and procedure, same choice will be shown here. So let me check this table and finish it. And model name is this, you can change this and thank you. Finish. Here is the connection string name, and in connection string, there is some behavior. SQL instance name, user ID, password, and data. So let's close it. Okay, so let's create a controller for CRUD operation. Create a new item, sorry. Click on controller, that is add. But first, before add the controller, you have to rebuild your project. Then you generated a new model. So it is a basic changes in your project. So you have to rebuild your project and add controller. Click on MVC view using entity framework. Click on this. Select the model, employee. Select your entity database first model for your scaffolding now. playing with this game. First of all, we have to run this game. So now let's throw the details. Details and back to the list. Input the details. Can you just click on? Okay, let's see. Now, if you want to delete this record, click on delete button. But this is same for your details. If you want to delete, okay, click on delete. So this is the basic example for database first and perform the cold operation. So thank you guys, thank you. I hope you enjoy this video and learn how to create this type of application. So thank you guys, and I have to say something about my channel. So just throw your C# code, Angular code, ASP.NET code, but just click on my subscribe button and don't forget to press the bell icon. Like, share, comment, please don't forget. Okay guys, thank you, and happy new year 2020 again. So have a nice day. Thank you.